and have a little Santa church. Not a little favourite of mine. Decided to come here today, have a quick look, see what goes on. So, these are the different areas that we've got here. Beautiful setting. Pretty gorgeous setting for it. Okay. Here we are. The wall. And the famous gate. So we'll open this gate up first of all. That's Samuel's grave. Everything that's in here. Got in here. Oh! Someone's laid some flowers. Got a little graveyard here. Quite nice. Beautiful little area here. Here we go, coming to the door. This is Saint Church by daylight. Beautiful window. Let's see the pattern there. Got that window here. Straight down the nave into the chancel and then to the altar. That was somebody outside, I think. Look at those beams, aren't they gorgeous? The vestry. Lots of all kinds of fun inside there. All kinds of things. I put me bag there. It's the list of rectors to the church. So what I'll do is
a great man nearing himself. 1636.
Actually,
these were actually on this side when the actual medieval church was here. This church was built in the 1600s. It was actually on top of the actual medieval church. And that's it.
One of the stories that came from here was a young lady came in to do floor work inside the church. And she came up through to here, and then as she turned, she saw a female sitting in that front pew by the door. That one. And with that, as she looked, the actual spirit just disappeared in front of her. That's one of the stories that I've heard a couple of times, which is interesting. That's the old famous haunted pew. There's some very strange people on the spring side here. Really strange. Got some geezer talking outside. One of the little windows there, quite nice. The famous pulpit. As you make your way up to there, sometimes I always say you be quiet, because our friend like to have a little swearing session as you go up there. Don't like you up there. I definitely had a wonderful swearing. He definitely had a really good swearing session to me. And I was there one night with the famous one of going, "Hey, you down there, I've seen your ass in communicator. If you disagree with this, you bitch, fuck, I'll scrap you out, old son." Yeah, I remember that, and that was fantastic. If you're listening, Rev, I will say thanks for that, because that was just wonderful. Now we've got this window here, which is quite nice. How nice is that, eh? Go with this one first. Isn't that lovely? That one. Really nice. Now we have this here. Now, we head into the chancel. There's that beautiful one there, that gorgeous, eh? Someone just coming in.
Hello.
Yeah.
Lovely.
It's a beautiful old church, this.
Tiny.
Absolutely gorgeous it is.
Yeah.
of the floors. It's again absolutely beautiful. So yeah, the old stand on little plinth. That's where the rat was buried, just in that spot just there. On the left hand side of the chancel. Of the old well, I mean, sorry, the old well. Been here before?
Sorry?
Have you been here before?
No.
It's gorgeous, isn't it? A little gem, this.
I have to ask the way.
Aha.
Well, I can see it on the map, but I couldn't see how to get in.
It's really tricky to find, actually.
I just found it in time, I've got to get back to work.
And this one here, and I say, was Thomas Bancroft's tomb. Thomas Bancroft, he was a tax collector. He wasn't what you could say a very popular man with being a tax collector. Nobody really liked him. He couldn't worship in his own parish. So Thomas had this church actually built himself. And he appointed the Reverend Richard Kendall to actually do the parish church, the vicar. Sometimes, as you know, we hear our friend having a little session for us, which we love to hear. So you had a little knock there. Thanks for that. Sadly, so many feet have now gone over that, so you can't really read what's actually been said on there. Can work out the lines, but sadly, not the words so much. Actually, it's quite good, actually. You might be able to when you get back home. You can actually see it on the video better than what you can with your naked eye. That's quite interesting. You can expect that. So this old church was built on top of the medieval church. So that was really interesting. Some say it's from some of the stone. Some of the actual work around here coming from West Toft's church. It's like this old chain there. Everybody asks for that to swirl, it never does, unfortunately. But we'd love to see it whirling around in the circle, but unfortunately we haven't been lucky enough to see that yet. And then we have the beautiful roof of the church. The church is a bat roost. Bat nursery, should I say. So we've got lots of bats in here. And as you can see on the window, a lot of people think that's all mice poo. No, it's not. That's all from bats. And the bats that there is here are long-eared bats. So that's the beauty of it, seeing them very often on the ghost hunt. We'll see them flying around, there and in. So that's always nice to see. With it being a bat nursery, we were asked to actually stay away from here during the beginning of May, the 1st of May, to the 1st of October.
to let the bats breed. So there's at the centre desk. And there's the wonderful door as you come in. Always a famous one when me and Chris came here. That was quite wonderful. The door opening by itself. Never forget that. I've seen it open and close many times, but never actually ever caught it on film. When Chris came here, that was the very first time we actually caught the church door opening. Always a day that was absolutely one of the fantastic days at the church. And one that I definitely will never forget. Thank you. Oh, hello. Got a strong feeling coming in right now. Really strong. Is it possible for you to say something? There's somebody outside there in the car. So when you hear the bang and the sound there, that's coming from that car. That's me. So I get these.
Blimey. I mean, so it's very heavy, my breath as I can see steam in front of my breath as it is. This one here is a little church that was made. It's a model of the church.
One of the very sad things that happened here, and I think it's around about the 80s, someone came in and they stole the altar. Not the altar, yeah. The font. They stole the font from here. It was very sad when that happened. So, never ever did get to see the font of the church, which is really sad. All I can hope for is our friend, our Rev, will curse that. Because whoever stole that stopped many people being able to see the wonders of that font. I've heard it was quite nice, despite never seeing it. Something that we've never had in the church up to present. That's
Marianne Cutter. Never had her
abrupt present come through as far as we know. Certainly never got a name mentioned. Obviously it must have been quite a big part of the congregation here. Me scraping along slowly. On the red screen, got these lovely little
rose style designs.
It's really pretty, actually. Absolutely love this rose green. It's so beautiful. You never see these at night, so it's just nice to be able to show you this. Whoever is on down this, we've got our spirit friends having a chat from time to time as well. Hope so. two lovely windows there.
A beautiful style design. Both look so the same as that one.
As each other. Now of course.
Blame God. Again.
Always beautiful. And then we've got that beautiful, gorgeous little roof there. This actual piece here, the original church, actually stopped the roof screen. That's how big the actual original church is. So anything past the roof screen at that point, that's Victorian. Because the chancel was a Victorian extension to the church. So this is Sun Church, a nice round circular view. And I'm just gonna sit and ask out. If you're here with us, could you let us know? Did you find it interesting as I was telling the story of the church? Would you say that I was accurate in what I said? The one thing I will say is, if we have any ghost hunters here watching, take a look at that lovely door. Never forget this one.
If you had a good night, put a couple of quid inside the box, church box. I always feel that if we had a good night ghost hunting, to put a quid inside there each. It's one of the things that I'm a firm believer in now. Oops. I'm just going to take this outside again.
I'm going to cool around the back of the church. Make a way around here. Again, something very rarely get to see. There's the beautiful tower there. And here we are around the back of the church. Here I've always had very strong feelings from. So one here. Picked up that there was an unmarked grave just there of a young girl. On One of the stories, the local stories, is that there was a taxi driver who dropped people off at to the houses at the back of the church. He decided he wanted to have a wee. With that, he went round the back of the, came around the back of the church here, have a wee. As he returned soon, he heard a young girl's voice giggling. So that's my interpretation of it, but whether she sounded like that, I don't know. All I know is that he said he just ran. Didn't like it. There's that tar again. Isn't that beautiful? Don't know what that bag is there.
May have a look in there for a little while.
This is where they believe the girl's body came in. It was actually buried. This area here, you can see it on the site. If you go on Facebook and put in Horner's Sand Church, you will see where they've actually marked out, where a group came down, marked out from through dowsing the walls of the old original medieval church. And round about at this spot here, just there, they actually marked out a very strong par node, which is an extra par of energy. Interesting. Ooh, we have stone inside there. Don't know what they're doing with stone, but maybe gonna repair something. The old drain. Maybe it's a lead. Not lead, slate. That's slate there. Another drain. Another windows. And now we come to the back of the church. And we've got a real gem here. How about that? Isn't that the most beautiful, beautiful gravestone? I absolutely love that. This of the Reverend Willa Pooley, as you can see. This might give them, we might have a nice little clean up one day. It's just so beautiful. We have a nice little
Scott sensation out there, like that. That's where the Lamb of God is.
You've got those two windows there. And basically, that's Sand Church. So I'm now going to go inside and have a plant my recorder in and see whether we get anything interesting. I like this. This is a lovely touch. Got the gravestones and somebody's put,
looks like the carnations on there. Yep, the carnations.
He's put those on there, but that's a beautiful, nice piece. Very nice. and oil can.
The other carnations there.
Absolutely beautiful. One of the ones that we have here are really, really small stones, really small. So I can give a little idea of that, of the size, by putting my foot there, like that, so you could actually see my foot, just so you can see how small that is. And I've got this one here. Another gravestone here. Got another tiny one here. Two birds are still visible. But yeah, again, I will show you how small that is. Really tiny. All but gone now. She can't make it out, but this is Samuel's grave. We actually had a spirit boy inside the church. He was, I believe, sort of being around about 8-9 years old. And the sad thing of this is that this grave is only a young boy of 9 years old. And his name was Samuel. At the time when we got this pickup, we didn't even realise that. We got those two there. Again, very small. As you can see, that's a bigger one. So, got this one here. Another quite delightful. I'm a bit surprised that you got that, but nobody put any carnations on that one. Must be just something about those two. Obviously means something to somebody. There's the wonderful, wonderful entrance to the church. And there we are. Please come in. I'm coming in. Nice little door knocker on there. Nice design.
That's the famous visits book. People would come here. Some really nice ones that come up there. People describing different hauntings they'd picked up on. Got one we read out. Some little girls writing. A lovely wee chick, but who's the little girl? The interesting part of that is, we do have a spirit in the church. Her name is Nicole. So in all capability, Nicole picked up Nicole and got to see Nicole.
We'd all love to see Nicole. I want to put these ones in.
How lovely are they, hey? Let's zoom in a little bit further. That's that one.
How beautiful is that, eh? Just to give you a see on the pattern we've got here. I tell you one of the things I find interesting. When I first came into the church, I could actually feel breath, see breath. Now I can't. So that's rather interesting. If you are here, can you say something, please? Strong sensation just come in. If you could tap on something. If that was you, thank you. Could you make that a little bit louder, please? Could you let us hear your footsteps, please? design. The church is so simply decorated and yet so beautifully decorated. I mean, it's that, but so simple, that design. But at the same time, how beautiful is it? There he is. Please say anything you possibly can. I came in here one night. Came in here one night and we got a lady singing. That was quite amazing. If you're here, can you say something, please? Try and say anything you possibly can. Is there any ladies in here that need help? If there is, let me know and I'll see what I can do. My nose. Ooh, I just heard a nice boom. That would have been a footstep. Quite nice. If there is anyone here, please try and let me know in any way you possibly can. I say, if you need help, I will try to do my best to help you if I can. Didn't hear anything there. Another bed boxes there, they're cute, aren't they? They really are. Like them. The old mat there. The style of the floor. Quite a few churches have actually got this style of tile work to the floor as you go through the chancel. And then down the nave of the church. So as you can see, the floor tile's gone through there. That's the actual aisle of the nave. I'm just going to turn this one off.